Today I'm going to show you how to stream to Twitch only using Ffmpeg without using OBS Studio. Let's get started. First of all, you have to have Ffmpeg installed on your machine and you will have to have your Twitch stream key. Okay, so I already have Ffmpeg installed on my Windows PC. It is very straightforward to install on either Windows, Mac or Linux. I'll link the tutorial in the description. First of all, you have to list down your input devices. Let's say I want to stream my desktop with my microphone. So I'm going to my command prompt, typing cmd, and here I'm pasting the command I have copied from here, which will list down the devices, supported devices on my PC. So here I have Elgato virtual camera, a focused audio interface on which the microphone is connected. I'll stream my desktop, enter desktop, and also voice. So if I want to show my camera, I can just open my camera. I'll be shown up here. Okay, so since I have listed down all the input and output devices connected to my PC, I'll have to use those to build my desired Ffmpeg command. So once you have Ffmpeg installed and you know what are the devices you can use with Ffmpeg, then you can go to Twitch, create a dashboard, setting, stream, and here you can copy the stream key. Okay, so now this is the command. This is the command I'll be using to stream to Twitch only using Ffmpeg. This approach is best for coding streaming, or if you want to stream without compromising the performance, or you have a very limited resource. Okay, so here the flag GDI grab is for Windows. To instruct that, the screen will be captured, the frame rate will be 30 fps, the input is enter desktop, flag tissue means other input. Here the audio input is my analog Focusrite USB 2 audio. So this audio interface have two microphone plug, and my microphone is plugged into the right one. This is the stereo interface, and on the right side the microphone is connected. So I know that I can use this as audio device, so I have copied it from here and put it in the double quotation. So once you have this command, you can just paste your audio input device here, and then the codec of the video is H.264. The preset is very fast. Now the thing I have mentioned earlier is my microphone is connected on the right channel of the stereo. So what I want to do is I want to map this right one to both left and right, so that when I stream, the audience will not only hear the sound on their right headphone or earbuds. So here I'm mapping the audio to both channel, and additionally I have used a compressor. So and here I have used the threshold of -20 dB to compress, and you can just follow this one or you can skip this compression part, doesn't matter. And the final output of the audio is AC, so the codec of audio is AC, and the bit rate is very good, 256. This is the audio signal hertz, and since we are streaming to Twitch, it has to be on FLV format. Very old school, but still adopted in the industry. And the URL of the Twitch stream, which is using RTMP module to ingest the stream from my PC to their streaming server. So here I have to paste my Twitch streaming key, which I'll be doing now. Once I have pasted the Twitch streaming key here, I can copy the full command, and I can go to my command prompt and paste the command here and press enter. So once I press enter, if everything is correct, the streaming will be started. Okay, so now if I go to Twitch, let's see what happens. I'm going to Twitch, stream manager tab. Now as you can see, I'm live now, so whatever I put on my display will be streamed here. So I'm opening my camera, so now you can see me. Whatever I want to say will be streamed to Twitch. If I start coding with ID, or if I start casual discussion or whatever, it will be streamed to Twitch right away. That's it. Whenever you want to close your stream, you can just press Ctrl and C at the same time. It will stop the streaming. So I'm closing my streaming to Twitch and it will stop streaming. Yeah, I'm offline now. So the streaming is closed. It is that easy. Ffmpeg is a very versatile tool for doing anything related to audio, video or any kind of media. So if you are into streaming and if you are not familiar with this tool, you should get the hang of this tool, because it will come very handy. You can download your VOD stream from Twitch and prepare it for YouTube. You can compress, you can convert, you can do noise reduction. And most importantly, you can stream to Twitch only with this tool, which is very efficient approach without needing OBS. So here are some of the things that Claude is saying that you can do with Twitch streaming. So let's see what it says. We can record local backup. It means you can stream to Twitch and also save a copy locally at the same time. You can stream replay buffer like last X minute without needing a GPU. And also you can convert from one format to another. You can process video, like if you want to put a watermark on your streaming, like in the top left corner a icon will appear. You can do that very easily with Ffmpeg. And also you can crop video, I mean anything that can be done with video while streaming, you can do that with Ffmpeg. And it is a very straightforward tool to install and very lightweight in size, very easy to use open source tool. You can even check out the source code of this project. So that's it. I hope you got the idea how you can stream to Twitch without using OBS or any other tool. And if you have learned something out of this video, please consider subscribing to my channel and don't forget to hit the like button. I'll show up with a new interesting technology in my next tutorial. So until that time, happy streaming.